Last week, we witnessed how on-ground threats and intimidation and social media attacks compelled Tanishq, that's part of Titan Industries, that's part of the Tata Group of Companies, to withdraw that ad featuring a Hindu-Muslim marriage in its storyline. It cited concerns over employee security. Now, the company hasn't said anything beyond that statement, and the ad agency that had made the commercial, after a few public appearances and comments, has stopped talking to the media, including CNBC TV 18. Now, both the backlash and the threats to this ad and therefore the company and its employees need to be seen in the broader context of society today, where there's a consistent attempt to muzzle free thinking and liberal values. On the Media Dialogues, I want to find out if brands can afford to stay in sanitized, storyboarded worlds, or if they need to be part of the zeitgeist, even if it means getting into trouble, serious trouble. I've invited a couple of cool and wise men to weigh in. Please welcome Santosh Desai, social commentator and managing director and CEO of Future Brands, and filmmaker Balki, who in his previous avatar was the creative powerhouse and chairman of the agency that's now called Mullen Lowe Lintas. Gentlemen, it's wonderful to see both of you. Thank you so much for joining me.
Pleasure.
So, Balki, what would you have done if you were in that hot seat at Titan and this brouhaha had broken out over this commercial that you had released?
I would have gone to the police and asked them for protection. That's the first thing I would have done. And I just believe that, the last thing I would have done is pull off the ad, but I would have asked for protection first. Because it's the job of the government or the powers that are to kind of give us the protection. Because otherwise, free speech means nothing. It's not even free speech. This is actually a very harmless kind of a really good and the right thing to do. If the right is going to be wrong, then I think the government ought to protect us. And I think that's what I would have asked for first.
Okay, Santosh, I'd really want each of you to take that stand unequivocally up front.
No, well, I mean, once I had decided to go ahead with the advertising and being fully aware of the fact that this was a sensitive sort of a subject, I would have backed it and I would have stayed, and I would have continued with the advertising. However, I mean, I would have thought, I certainly would have not have gone into it with my eyes closed, believing that this was just another creative campaign and that it would have no backlash. I mean, you would have to be deaf, dumb and blind in today's India to believe that this would not get a reaction.
I just have a different point of view from Santosh on this one, because I believe the marketing team would have actually said people would applaud this entire thing, because it shows a kind of, harmonious kind of existence between this thing. I understand what's going on in the country, but these are things that these are the right things to do. This is how whatever we do, whatever even the, let's say, the current establishment is kind of doing, the projection is this of harmony. I mean, at least the projection, the talk on the surface, you would never have the prime minister coming and saying something against a kind of religion or whatever. Sure. It is kind of, at least the portrayal ought to be one of harmony. And that's what this ad is doing. So I don't agree that somebody would have gone into this thing with blind. I just feel that they would not have thought that they're doing anything against or detrimental to anybody or any religion. This is just a harmonious existence of two kind of religions. So I feel that it's actually a nice space to be. I don't think people would have gone into this with so much of thought, because this is not that controversial on the face of it, because there is no controversy.
Okay, let me get Santosh back in. Santosh, really, Balki, I get the point Balki makes about the fact that it is a positive, idea that's part of the storyline, or that the storyline perpetuates in this ad. But Balki is suggesting that people in ad agencies, people on brand teams are not at all plugged into or are living in cocoons or not plugged into reality.
I never said that.
You didn't say that, but you seem to suggest that.
I never said that. I said in this ad, look at it. I mean, it could have, on another day, the same establishment, same government, it could have just passed like that. A few months back, before all this kind of chaos happened, it could have just kind of passed like that. Nothing would have happened. It just happens sometimes, we kind of read too much into something that happens because of an environment that's existing just for these few months. Trust me when I tell you this, about 8 months back or 9 months back, or even just a year back, if this ad had come, it wouldn't have kind of caused any kind of ripples.
Santosh? You know,
it would just gone.
Okay, let Santosh weigh in.
I absolutely disagree with that. But I do think that, you know, this is I envy Balki's innocence in some senses. I agree with him on the fact that this is an innocent ad. It is a pure ad. I mean, in any normal society, this is an ad that should be welcomed. I mean, it is not, there are some ads that try and stir up controversy, that are actually poking at things in order to get a reaction. This is not one of those ads. I agree with him there. But that's where it stops. Because, if you at all been kind of tuning in to the kind of reactions that on social media, anything, any small attempt where, you know, there is any depiction or any representation of anything Muslim, and you see the reaction there, if you have been tuning into that, and not just for the last 8-9 months, but for the last few years, I think it would be impossible for anyone not to anticipate the fact that this would run into rough weather. Because, you know, with the whole love jihad thing that is happening, I mean, the NCW sort of a chairperson has very casually tweeted that I met the governor of Maharashtra and among other people discussed love jihad. As if it were a thing, as if it is a thing that the National Commission for Women, the chairperson, has legitimized the idea of love jihad. So I think in today's context, perhaps to the point of being overcautious, perhaps to the point of being paranoid, brands have a responsibility to think through all possible reactions whatever they do, not just advertising, but whatever they do, what that might provoke. And I think that it is, even if your intention, I absolutely agree, your intentions may be as pure as you like, but you cannot ignore the fact that there is an ecosystem here that is vitiated, that there are attempts that are agendas, not just, and I just want to make it about the liberal versus the sort of right, equally on the liberal side. I mean, which is what in my recent column, I pointed out that there was, some time back, Titan had released a set of ads, a campaign for Tamil Nadu for a special range of watches made for to represent, Tamil culture, and which was found to be too Brahminical. And there was a reaction against it, and they withdrew the advertising then also. And so it's not, I'm not trying to make the point that, the overall environment on all sides of the political kind of spectrum, you find that there is a touchiness and there is also a willingness to use the power of social media to make oneself heard and to very aggressively and assertively attack any form of representation. So I think this is something that, and given the fact that Titan went through it a few months ago, for them not to sort of tune into this, I find it difficult to agree with Balki on this particular thing.
You know, Balki, you've done campaigns which has plugged into the zeitgeist. They are of different kind, and the times we were living in were also very different. Having said that, they did make statements, they did take stances. I'm talking about the Idea campaign, I'm talking about, Tata Jagore, stuff like that. What is it that goes into the thinking at the creative end, at the brand's end, when it comes to directly engaging with what's going on in the reality around you, in the times we are living in?
I'll tell you something, in the environment that we live in, we don't know what is going to get you into trouble. You don't know, whatever you do, somebody could kind of find some kind of fault in it. So to plan for everything out there is almost impossible. What you need to do is just take a stance, is simply saying, I'll fight it. I'll fight it when something comes, because I think it's really important to first stop reading this trolling as some major kind of opposition that exists in the universe. I think it's social media trolling. I mean, it's not even anything. Just, you have to find a way to kind of fight it as a brand. You need to know how to ignore it, or you need to say that this is really not affecting my brand at all. It is some bunch of goons who are kind of doing this kind of thing. It's all about preparing as a company. If you're going to be daring and if you're going to be cutting edge as a company, you also need to be prepared to fight any battle that comes up, because you don't know what the battle you're going to fight. Anything that you do tomorrow. Today, if I done the widow remarriage ad, for example, Tanish, who knows which conservative person may come up and say tomorrow, how can you do this particular stuff with a child out there? How can you propagate this stuff? Today, if I do Jagore and asking a politician for qualifications to kind of stand for an election, people say, how dare you kind of do this? Are you mocking so-and-so? Are you mocking so-and-so? So you can do anything today and there will always be a problem. It's not about the ability to kind of forecast every problem that comes to you. You can't do anything in life. It's all about finding a way to fight it, finding cleverer and cleverer ways to kind of fight it. As much as they are creating the trouble, we also need to find solutions very cleverly and creatively. How do you battle this? It's not, you cannot anticipate what's coming tomorrow. You can't prepare for every battle. You cannot.
Santosh, how do you battle it? Do you just stay away? Do brands just stay away from the real world? Do they live in sanitized versions of La La Land where they just talk about happy families and happiness as a result of certain products and services that they use? What is the way forward? Because it seems to be very booby-trapped out there for brands, as it is for individuals.
Well, the truth is that, you know, brands through history and through till very recently only talked about happy people and doing happy things, or, you know, people who are, you know, where their skin was not, you know, glowing enough or whatever. So, I mean, if it's some, the brands are not beacons of you know, democracy. I mean,
sure, they're not meant to be. But in today's world, is that change?
I mean, let's keep some perspective on this. The fact that brands don't have not historically been, you know, and in fact, it always, you know, it always boggles me when, you know, I find people from media, I mean, and I don't mean you specifically, but attacking brands, because media is supposed to do this job and they have abdicated this job. And now, because brands are saying it, you know, once in a while, you cannot suddenly transfer the burden of speaking truth to power to brands and saying you should be courageous, but we will not be. We will self-censor and we will kind of be cheerleaders for the most horrible things on earth while you take on the responsibility of you know, being the kind of noble and righteous people. So firstly, I do think that that's a point that I would certainly want to make. Apart from that, I do think that, yes, I mean, you know, should brands stand up? Yes, I think it is important for brands to take, you know, believe in things, go into things with their eyes open, and then, you know, stand up for what they believe in. But if you blunder into areas that are, you know, that are bigger than what you actually want to take responsibility for, then there is a price to be paid. And, you know, I agree with Balki up to a point when he says that, you know, social media trolling is, you know, we just have to get used to it. It's just, the thing about it is that it feels very overwhelming in the moment, but it's also transient. You know,
But it's also coupled with physical threats and intimidation and targeting of people. I mean, it, you know, we know there was a hashtag trending with an employee's name of Titan who probably had nothing really directly to do with the campaign or definitely didn't have the powers to green light something like this.
So let me complete what I was saying. So I agree with you. So what I'm saying is that at one level, you can ignore social media trolling, but not in this case. When you actually believe that the implicit power, implicitly the state is backs such kind of polling. See, the problem, I suspect, and I'm only guessing here, the problem is not the fact that Titan was afraid of social media training or polling, but the fact that this is part of the dominant political narrative of the day, and therefore this will not, I mean, when Balki says seek police protection, we've seen in all other instances, and not just this government, even previous governments, when it comes to the freedom of speech, no government has protected, whether it was for films, or whether it is for anything, that no government has stood up for freedom of speech, which is the reason why, even if there were relatively small threats and there were intimidatory tactics, they become real and they become something to be afraid of. I think
there were real threats that were reported where showrooms in Gujarat were threatened by people, apologies were pasted on showroom, you know, glass windows, etc. But having said that, the point you make this point about it's a bit rich that media is asking these questions. Now, I'm not going to stand here and apologize for the rest of the industry. I speak for myself and the channel that I'm on. So my question is, I'm going to avoid what is a classic case of whataboutry, okay? So media, what my role is and what the media's role is vis-a-vis brand, we know. Question is, should brands navigate these waters? Should brands take a stand? Are they expected to take a stand by their consumers or by the society at large? Balki, and then I'll come back to you, Santosh.
Of course, brands should take a stand. when it's necessary, if it's in the personality, the brand takes chances. Like in Tanishq, it's all about a twist in tradition. It's all about kind of doing the progressive thing. It's all about kind of thinking openly, thinking freely. So I think when a brand has taken a stance like that, when it stands for something like this, these are like almost vanilla stuff for something like that, somebody like Tanishq. This should be done automatically. So I feel, yes, brands should take stances, and brands shouldn't forcefully take stances because when their entire personality is not like that, or when they haven't ever stood for something like that, then they should do the fun and dance, happy things and then all together. So you don't have to always take stances, but if you already stand for taking stances, please continue doing so, and please fight for those stances, because there are going to be oppositions. They will come forward, and I think we need to learn to fight. What we haven't understood as a culture, both in brands as well as films, is about how to fight. Whenever there's trouble, we kind of either say, oh shit, I don't want to go through that trouble, or we look at that overwhelming kind of force of opposition and kind of keep quiet, say, better to kind of keep quiet. Somewhere, I just feel that we kind of keep celebrating people who fought the system and keep forgetting, whenever we get an opportunity to fight the system, we forget that's an opportunity to fight the system. That's the battle, you know, because there are going to be more and more opportunities for us to kind of get through this entire thing, fight this entire thing. So we need to plot how to fight, because everything is going to be a fight. You cannot stand still, you cannot think it through, you cannot have solutions for everything in this environment, but you need to have a plan to keep fighting in different ways for different problems. So what if I didn't think about this entire thing? I was dumb, okay? So I was a dumb marketer. I was a dumb advertising person. I thought I was in La La Land, and I was in a beautiful country which is supposed to be this country, where we kind of celebrate all religions, and I truly do it according to the constitution of this country, and I faced this backlash. What would I do? Would I say, oh shit, I'm sorry. That means I'm accepting that I've done something wrong. No, I would say, oh shit, I didn't anticipate this problem, but hey, I didn't do anything wrong. Please let's try and fight.
Do you see Tanishq as a brand, you know, stronger or weaker as a result of this episode? Because you have seen an outpouring of support. You've seen a lot of anecdotal stories being shared on the same social media that was against this ad, of interfaith marriages and experiences. Do you see the brand stronger or weaker as a result of the actions of the company of taking down the ad?
See, I think more people have seen this ad because of this than they would have seen the Tanishq, than they would have seen most ads.
Yeah.
So that way, I think Tanishq's message about whatever they want to do in the ad has kind of reached people. The fact that they pulled off the ad and what it cost their image, it's going to just affect a few people. But for most people, they would have seen the ad and they would still think Tanishq is a damn good brand, because for whatever reason they've seen the ad. So I don't think it would affect Tanishq at all. But, you know, I just want to say one thing here. It's not necessarily brands in their advertising need to take stances. Even brands as companies kind of take stances. Like take Bajaj, for example.
Yeah.
I don't think any of their brands are taking stances in social issues or anything of that sort right now. But the owner of the company, the MD of the company is actually kind of taking a stance saying, I won't do this. So that actually does a lot for the image of Bajaj, because it's standing up for the right thing. Yes, he may get trolled. Yes, he may do this stuff, but somebody is taking a very clear stance. So I think brands can kind of, you know,
distinguish the corporate identity and brand from the product brands and identity.
Yeah, they can. It doesn't always have to be in advertising or a commercial. Some brands have to do it through commercials. Some brands can do it in any other way. But all of us today have to start standing for the right thing. You cannot play this dual game of saying, okay, let's kind of make money on the side. Let's be sharply built. Let's not kind of disrupt the system. Because I feel we are living in a dangerous society. And all of us need to do our little bit, whether it's through advertising, whether it's through speaking up, whether it's thing to kind of set things right. It cannot go on like this. So I don't think brands are in the isolated space that they were a few years back, where they are all about, you know, what appeals to the consumer, what is relevant to them, let's sell it to them. It's no longer that kind of thing. I think brands need to do that 20% extra to kind of do something to set things right.
Santosh, Tanishq stronger, weaker as a result of this whole episode?
I don't think it's weaker. I do think that one, of course, that a lot of people would have ended up seeing the ad. And I also think that the group of people who are protesting is not necessarily the consumer base of Tanishq. I'm not arguing the opposite. I'm not saying that there is no overlap at all. But the fact that that's a different strand. You know, that's a different set of concerns and a different set of people for whom that, you know, this issue is that salient for it to, you know, have done the kind of trolling that they've done. Certainly, some part of the Tanishq consumer base has rallied behind the brand. Even the act of pulling out the advertising, I sometimes feel that, you know, it's just because it has become a thing, but otherwise ads come and go. Nobody notices when ads are pulled out, so to speak, or taken off air.
Satosh, Balki just referred to the Bajaj brand and, you know, the product advertising and stances and the distinction between that and what the corporate brand represented by the company's managing director represents. Do you think here the Tanishq brand is unaffected, but perhaps two discerning audiences, the Tata Group brand or the Titan Industries brand, has come in a little bit weaker?
I do think that there will be a bunch of people who have felt sad at the fact and have felt a little disappointed at the fact that the company has acted the way that it has. And so to that extent, yes. But I think the overall fund of goodwill that both the Tatas and Titan have, I think, is very large. So I do think that a one-off event it doesn't affect the brand, but I don't think it has a lasting kind of an effect on the brand. But if it becomes a pattern, if it is something that you know happens over and over again, then obviously then the credibility of taking any position gets weakened.
Okay, final question to both.
But I am a little disappointed with the Tatas, because it's a company that stands for what India stands for, a kind of a personality of India, which is all inclusive. And I feel that the fact they haven't fought, it's not about pulling off the ad or doing the ad or not doing the ad. It's about not fighting for what people are objecting against, you know, fighting for that stuff. It's a very important statement. And I also feel that the Tatas must have a lot of Muslim employees. It's actually letting a lot of them down by saying that, this has disturbed some people. It's wrong. To me, that to me is disappointing,
so,
for sure.
So also, Balki, we don't know what they're doing behind the scenes, and they are citing employee security as a result, as the reason for their actions. But having said that, you're saying that they need to be publicly out there defending. So you have to
asking for protection. See, at least kind of, I understand pulling up the ad saying that we can't run it because their employees are under threat and everything else. But I think you should fight for protection for my employees so that I can run this ad. Not saying that I pulled it off because my employees were threatened, and keep quiet about it. I feel there should be ways to kind of get this ad on again.
All right. Final question to both of you, starting with Santosh. We've had industry bodies come out in support. We have seen well-meaning people come out in support. Do you see this changing the way brands behave going forward? What are the broader final big picture ramifications?
I think I would see two kinds of reactions. One is that there will be some brands that will prefer to play it safe and be cautious and not venture into territories that they think are troublesome. But there will be a smaller group of brands, which will actually, take stands and decide to stick by them. I think there is reason enough for both kinds of reactions. For the cautious one, which might be the larger number, but I think there will be a smaller group of brands that will, think through things and take positions and stick by them.
Okay, Balki, final word to you.
I really don't know the answer to that, because I think there will be some people in some companies who will say enough is enough and we're not going to take this and rub that off onto their brands. But there are some people who are going to say, who's going to go through this trouble of fighting this? Let's do those vanilla stuff, boring stuff. Let's not do anything controversial. Yes, I know enough number of people are going to do that. And there will be a few people who are going to say, listen, we are part of this ecosystem and we need to do something about it. There will be a few people.
All right. Okay. There will be brands that will take stands. Gentlemen, thank you very much for joining us. And thank you very much for watching. Do tune in next week for another edition of the Media Dialogues.